The Palestinian Authority on Wednesday announced another lockdown throughout the West Bank after a sharp increase in coronavirus infections. Palestinian government spokesman Ibrahim Milhem announced, starting from Friday morning, all governorates of the West Bank will be closed for a period of 5 days. The only businesses allowed to stay open are pharmacies, bakeries, and supermarkets. Coronavirus numbers soared in recent days throughout the West Bank. So far, 2,686 people had tested positive for COVID-19 since the outbreak of the pandemic in the Palestinian territories, compared to 1,256 just last week. Our Arab Affairs correspondent, Dima Abu Maria, took to the streets of Ramallah to gauge people's reaction.
The Palestinian Authority said it has no choice but to reinforce strict curfew measures to contain the spreading of the coronavirus pandemic. But not all Palestinians are happy with the decision.
Jirias Rayan, the owner of a money exchange store in Ramallah, says they are still trying to recover from the first closure.
The closure period was long and has damaged the economy and citizens' incomes as well. People were affected negatively. They accumulated debt and the employment rate increased.
Rayan says the second closure will be devastating.
In general, closing Palestinian cities completely for 5 days will paralyze the economy and negatively affect people's living conditions. The consequences for the Palestinian economy, which is already suffering financially because of the global pandemic and the Israeli occupation, might be catastrophic.
Others think the government decision doesn't go far enough.
I support the closure decision. I think it's a good one as it will protect people, but 5 days aren't enough. And the government should have closed cities a long time ago. People's lives are more important than money. Businesses can be compensated, but health cannot be compensated.
The PA first imposed a widespread lockdown in early March after the first coronavirus cases were recorded. The closure was lifted in May. Munif al-Barghouti urged the PA to think about its decisions before taking them.
I think the closure decision should be carefully studied and not taken arbitrarily. People don't have money and have been badly affected. With another closure, they won't be able to earn any money. This doesn't work. The government should at least support these people. I feel like there is randomness in these decisions.
Israel also witnessed a spike in coronavirus infection cases. So far, about 26,000 confirmed cases in Israel. 980 of them were just in the past 24 hours, the highest one-day count yet.
From Al Manara Square in the city center of the West Bank city of Ramallah, this is Dima Abu Maria reporting for the Media Line.